MailerLite subscribers are divided into groups and segments. Both allow you to organize subscribers together in order to send them more targeted marketing campaigns or automations, but they work differently.
When using segments, we're grouping subscribers together based on common traits. Segments have at least one rule or condition, and the subscribers are automatically added to the list if they meet those conditions, and they're removed from the list if they don't. These lists are dynamic and they change based on subscribers' information, so you cannot just manually add or remove subscribers from these segments or use them to trigger automations. Meanwhile, groups don't have rules or criteria that subscribers have to meet, so they are not automatically updated. You can manually add and remove subscribers from groups and use them to trigger automations. To access your groups in your subscriber zone, click on Groups. Here are all the groups that I already have in my account. By selecting one or more groups, you will be able to delete or merge the groups. To create a new group, click on Create Group, give it a name, and click Create. And here's your new group. When clicking on View Group, you can see that the search filter is already set with the name of the group. So scrolling down will reveal all of the subscribers that belong to this group. Go over to the Stats tab and you can see the statistics of your groups, including the average open, click, subscriber, and unsubscribe rate. Check how engaged your different groups are and even the environment where they're reading your emails. You can check these stats for all of your subscribers or check the specific group stats by choosing a group from the drop-down menu right here. Let's look at how groups are used within forms in your account. In order to add subscribers to a form, it must be connected to a group. So now looking at the overview setting of any form, you can see what group is connected to that form. You can change the group or add more than one group. So now subscribers are added to multiple groups when they sign up to this form. When creating a campaign, you'll notice that you have the option to choose the recipient groups, which will determine who receives your newsletter. You can also exclude a group, so that subscriber in that group will not receive your campaign, even if they're a part of one of the included groups. When adding a survey or a quiz to your newsletter, you can set up a custom rule that will add a subscriber directly into your chosen group when they answer your survey or quiz questions. You can even add subscribers to different groups based on their answers. Make sure to check our video tutorial on how to add a survey or quiz in your newsletter. So a subscriber has been added to a group. Now what? To start sending automatic emails when a subscriber is added to a group, simply set up an automation using the trigger when a subscriber joins a group. Then the subscriber will enter the workflow immediately after joining that group. If you want to add a subscriber to a group at some point while they're going through your automation, you just need to add an action step and choose copy or move to a group. So you can make sure subscribers are being segmented to the right place. All right, these are all the basics you need to know for now about groups, and if you want to learn more, you can visit our YouTube channel.
Thanks for watching! Make sure to click the bell button below so you don't miss any new tutorials. You can also find us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and subscribe to our newsletter. The link is in the description section below. Have an awesome day or night, and I'll see you in the next video.